Hello everybody, my name is Eric and I hunt for collectibles, and if you want to see what I found this week, stay tuned. So as you know, I hunt for collectibles, and what is new that I'm finally going to resell. Yes, the day happened. So I've decided to go full-time reselling. So if you see anything in this video or in previous videos, and just maybe I didn't sell it yet, let me know, leave a comment, contact me at info@ericscollectibles.nl. And I will get back to you and see what we can do. So I was hunting in the very south of the Netherlands, and I went to almost a dozen thrift stores, some antique stores, antique stores, etc., secondhand stores, and they are nowhere near the same size as they are in the US. In the Netherlands, they are much smaller, so it was also a bit awkward to video there, so we didn't video much, but let me do show you the things that I found. So I hunted solely for what I think are nice collectibles from the 70s, 80s, sometimes 90s. I tried to search for old toys, video games, etc., and old technology, and this is what I found. Let me show you. First of all, I've got a stack of video games. They are not the most valuable ones. I bought this for the Wii. I've got Wild Series Poker, CSI, Hard Evidence, North American Hunting Extravaganza, which is like an 8-euro game. For PlayStation 3, I've got God of War 3, Infamous, Burnout Paradise Ultimate Box. Then for PlayStation 2, Horses Games. This one is actually a bit difficult to find online, but I don't think it's very valuable. Yeah, another Horses game, Sims 2 Pets. Then we've got Mythmakers, Orbs of Doom, Pirates of the Caribbean, SingStar R&B, World Tour, and Black. Then I also found some cartridge games. I will show you two already now. This is the Menacer 6 game cartridge for the Mega Drive, Sega Mega Drive.
With a Sega Menacer in my hands, I'm not afraid of scuzzy criminals, enemy tanks, slimy aliens. Give your Aunt Bertha a big kiss.
Well, almost nothing.
The Sega Menacer, with 6 different games and 4 ways to play.
And I've got this a bit, yeah, poor version of the Game Boy Tetris, but it's working, so that's always nice. Then, what else did I buy? I bought this Buddy L Crane. Pretty nice. Decals are on there, so that's a good one. Sorry about the loud noise. And I also bought this one, which I think is a Buddy L, but what was I thinking? So I shouldn't have bought this. When I came back home, I noticed first of all there is quite some damage to it. The windshield is somewhat damaged, and it's missing something on the front, I think. So yeah, I think it has to be discounted. I shouldn't have bought this. It's not the quality that I actually want. Yeah, I bought this 8mm reel for Speedy Gonzalez. Somebody might want that. I bought this Laserdisc Cutthroat Island.
Seek my treasure, have you?
It's actually quite difficult to find laser discs in the Netherlands. And there's not a huge following for it, but yeah, I did buy it because yeah, it's a bit of a strange technology, so I like buying laser discs for cheap. What else did I buy? And if you're not from the Netherlands, you might not have heard of these. So I've got Flippos. So Flippos, you might know them in the US as Pogs. And what they did in the Netherlands with potato chips from Lay's or Smith's, as they were called back then, somewhere around 1993, they put these Pogs, these Flippos, in with the potato chips. And so they were collected quite a few, and as you can see, they made hundreds of them. So there are a couple very valuable ones, but they are not in here. I've got two stacks of them. They are folder 1 and 2. These the more valuable Flippos to look out for are the famous gold Flippo. You know, I'm not sure exactly what you had to do for that. A gold Flippo is very difficult to find. It's actually, if I remember, 8-carat gold Flippo. And they made a set with Christmas Flippos, only for the people working at the factory. So you can imagine that's difficult to find. So those, unfortunately, are not in these folders. But it's a nice collection anyway. And believe it or not, they are becoming a bit more difficult to find, even though they made millions of these Flippos. In nice folders like this, they are becoming a bit more difficult to find and becoming a bit more collectible. So for the right amount of money, I decided to buy them. So I picked up Pet Shop Boys and I picked up this final album, which is blatant ripoff of Indiana Jones. And as you've seen in my logo already, I am quite fond of that, so I decided to pick this up just for fun. It's not a very interesting album, except for the logo and the cover, to be honest. So not really Indiana Jones lookalike. Denzel in Distress. Raiders of the Pop Charts, that you had to laugh a lot. And I bought it for €1. I finally found a shop that had really old cartridge video games. And I was able to pick this up for the NES Mission Impossible. Paperboy, which I think is the best of this stack. Shadowgate. And Solstice. And before I get to that stack, I will show you this. In another thrift store, I found this Texas Instruments TI-58 programmable calculator. If you haven't heard of it, I made a whole video just about this TI-58 and the TI-59, which have a huge following. Regrettably, the battery was totally roached. Here it is. You can see it's totally roached. So I have to take out these ugly batteries and I will sell this for parts. And also for parts it's huge money still. So it's I think it's a 20-30 euro calculator in non-working state, and it would be double that if it were. So back to the video games. I bought for the Super NES Bubsy. I'll put it in plastic, sorry for that. And then I get to the best two, I think. I've got Secret of Evermore, which is, I think, a 40 euro game. And this might not be as valuable as that, but it's sealed for the Atari 2600. Very difficult to find in the Netherlands. Pole Position. I think that's it. Yeah, that's for all the finds that I did. So this is all the total of collectible finds that I did in, I think, 11 thrift stores. So you can imagine it was quite a ride, but the whole day of searching. But that's it. That's what I found. So those will go into my pile. So watch that on ericscollectibles.nl. I put the link there as well. And stay tuned, and I will make much more videos in the near future. Thank you very much for watching now. Let me know what is your favorite find that I've shown you. Did you search for any of these, or are you searching for similar collectibles? Let me know. I've got a huge deck, and yeah, as I've said, you might be the first to be able to buy it for me. So thanks again for watching. Stay safe and bye for now.